Oklahoma so far?
It's beautiful, beautiful. I took a couple of runs up there. Weather's been great. I got a little bit of rain on the second one. It was cool. I took a long load of cable. It's crazy, man. I went from where did I go from? I went from Guymon, Oklahoma, to Idabel. So I went from
So you went from Fort Worth up to Guymon.
I did.
Guymon all the way to Idabel. So you crossed the whole state.
Yeah.
Oh wow! In just a couple of days.
Just today, actually.
Today, holy cow!
Yeah, I was because I last week I had videos to post every day, and oh, nice. I was pulling some good numbers, and I got some good interactions, some very nice people reaching out, giving me likes, saying hi, really happy. Then the weekend came, and I don't really post on the weekends, and then I had nothing for Monday and Tuesday, and I'm like, God dang it, I got to get something, you know?
Yeah,
get something. So I went through and I'm like, okay, well, I'll set up and I'll do a couple runs in Oklahoma and just kind of do that, you know? And just after I got everything set up and I was just sitting down, I got your text. I'm like, you got to be kidding me.
What did I say?
You're like, hey, we driving tonight? And I'm like, okay. So I just went ahead and I grabbed two runs and like I said, I went from Fort Worth to Guymon and then Guymon to Idabel. Idabel, there's the Beaver State Park, which was fun trying to drive through with a really long load. So that was it. And if you're going to, are you doing the cruising Oklahoma? Did you buy it while you were away or did you not?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I bought it on the cruise when I was in Jamaica.
Technology, isn't it awesome?
I know. So I got that and Shadows of Doubt. So yeah, I came back, I loaded the sucker up and yeah, I think I'm going to drive every other Tuesday.
Yeah.
And just make it like this, and then another 2 weeks, and every 2 weeks I'll just do an open convoy. I mean, open to anyone on the channel who wants to come in, and if you want to drive that way, we're driving every other Tuesday, driving twice a month for a couple hours, and starting to cover some of this map. At least that's my plan.
Sounds good. Yeah, I mean, I don't know if I'll drive convoy every time. I'm doing some of my own stuff, but
yeah, well, and even if we weren't convoying, like if you're available that night and you're somewhere else in the country, just being on the same server, we could chat with each other while you're driving wherever you're at. And I'm like, now, like I just booked a job to go up to Ardmore.
Ardmore,
that's just south central.
I've heard you don't want to be in Ardmore after nightfall.
Because it's one of those three cities where they have a thing, you know, with stuff.
A truck dealer?
Yeah. Yeah, so I'm going to see if there's a Mack dealer there. If it's not there, then I'll, go Oklahoma City or Enid and try and eventually get my next truck.
Enid. I got a load going to Enid.
Ah, all right.
EPR. I haven't driven for EPR. They're Aromatics.
Oh.
It's a normal delivery, but it is a hazard class 3.
Ooh.
So do you want to check out Ardmore and I'll check out Enid?
Sure. Okay. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like, I don't want to be like, here, this is what we're doing. Like, even for other people who stumble on the channel and be like, come on in, get on the server and drive wherever you're driving, and then talk on the CB if you feel like talking. But in our case, we just talk the whole time because we don't
shut
up.
That's true.
So, we
got to feed the beast. We got to feed the beast, man.
Yeah. Well, I was on the trip. I got a couple chances. I got to sit and listen to some stuff. And it was like, so I'm watching our last couple of videos back. Or listening, more like.
Yeah, and that was a good idea to go ahead and we cranked out those two runs in one night, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And then I was able to kind of handle that business.
Drive safe.
Yeah.
All right, so I've got 89 degrees at 2:48 in the afternoon.
Yeah, I got 96. It's hotter down here. 2:40. Okay, yeah, it's 2:58. I got 2:58. How come I have 2:58 and you have 2:40? That doesn't make sense.
I got
We're in the same time zone.
2:41 now. I mean 2:51. 2:301. I'm up over 3 o'clock. Holy crap!
Okay, yeah. So your clock caught up to mine.
Looks that way.
Okay.
Yep.
Oh my gosh.
I got my windows down.
Still trying to figure out my shifter situation here. I have a little difficulty with the shifters. So I'm in Fort Worth, and there's a stadium out here. What stadium would that be? You happen to know?
No, I don't.
I can't read it. University of Texas.
There you go.
Aggies? Is that?
I don't know.
Gig'em?
Isn't that the frog from the cereal?
Dig'em? From what?
The cereal? Dig'em?
No, right, Gina.
I gotta go 70 to EPR. Okay.
Would always go down to Texas for work. And I can't remember if it was the University of Texas Aggies or if it was Texas A&M Aggies. I don't know.
I think Aggie sounds more.
Yeah. Yeah, Texas A&M Agriculture and Mining, so that makes sense. So how you been in the last week?
I've been well. How was your trip?
That was good. Yeah, I mean, we, you know, Peruvian cruise. It's hot. And so for like a week, I was either wet, sweaty, you know, and very infrequently cool and dry.
Yeah.
But it's beautiful. I'll have to share pictures at some point. And,
sir.
Great.
Very cool.
Got a little bug down in Mexico. Had to stay near a bathroom.
Oh.
But nothing too bad.
Well, that's good.
So I think this is Fort Worth right here. So I've been to Fort Worth in real life. Highway out here. So what's going on out there by you where you're at right now?
Nothing. Whole lot of nothing. Oh man, I am waiting to get across here. Got a lot of traffic. A lot of traffic happening.
Resuming baseball tomorrow?
Yes, sir. Yeah, I miss it actually.
Yeah. I can't. We're at home, right? Who are we facing, do you know?
I think it's the Sawteeth.
That's right. That's right. Hey, this does look like Fort Worth. It's well rendered.
Keep right.
Very good.
And then turn right.
I've never been to Texas or turn Oklahoma.
Right.
So it's all new to me, but Oklahoma is surprisingly hilly.
Yeah.
Like I said, when you get to that eastern.
Yeah.
Corner, that southeastern corner, it's actually, yeah, it was very hilly.
I did business when I was in my last role within the oil and gas sector. We dealt with Farmers National Company, which were our mineral managers, and they were based in Tulsa. I just talked to our mineral manager out there about what it's like to live in Tulsa, and he said, yeah, the eastern end of the state is, you know, really wooded and hilly and not what you expect with the rest of the state's kind of the open plains, kind of like Nebraska, Kansas.
Yeah. And that's kind of what you picture when you talk about it. You think about Texas, Oklahoma. There's some horses. You kind of you think of flat, open land, you know?
Yeah.
I can't remember. Was it Beaver Dam? I think it was Beaver Dam National forest or something. It was really cool.
And then turn left.
They had saw in Oklahoma there?
Yeah. They got a little movie and everything that you get to pull up and enjoy.
Somebody get to see those, right? Those are going to be on your channel?
Yeah, they should be.
Turn left.
And so by the time this airs, folks, and you're watching this, you will already have seen these MPs. You'll be like, yeah, duh.
Yeah. Yeah. Including the what happened to me with the... Uh-oh, there's an accident happening over here. Why is this guy in the wrong lane? This guy is in oncoming lane. I've never seen the NPC characters drive. This guy literally is in the oncoming traffic lane. Nobody can move. He keeps backing up and then pulling forward, right? That is the weirdest thing I have never seen. I'm not going to make this light, because...
And that's another thing, too. It's really, folks, when you're watching Pete and I, you check both of our channels and shit.
Yeah.
Because it's so much fun to, like, I can hear you talking, and I'm just looking around. I'm just driving over high. I'm like, all right, whatever. And then I get to check yours out and see what you're actually dealing with.
Compare and contrast. That's why I got the two monitors set up.
Yeah.
So I sync it up. I sync up the audio, and then I just watch the two videos.
Oh, that's fun. I've never done that yet. Well, I mean, hopefully, if I stick to this and start doing this every 2 weeks, if there are people on the channel who want to join us, we could eventually, you know, have other people and other channels that we check out. If, you know, Bill Thornton's ever able to join us, it'd be neat to see him on here. Also, we got that other guy. I'm still connected to him on Discord that we drove with that one time. He's always asking to drive, so I should just shoot him a message and say, hey, you know, every other Tuesday, if you wanna. He drives for a
Was that you?
Yeah, I accidentally hit the CV.
Okay.
Yeah, if it's usually a beep, then it's me hitting the wrong button. I got my CV button is just north of my okay, I don't get it. I'm here. I don't see. I thought I selected a job. I'm not Mimik. Oops. I'm here. Did I? It's a navigation ended.
Huh.
But there's no like pickup spot. I don't see my trailer. Unless I just pull in here. I don't even remember what. Okay, so if I hit escape.
Did it time out?
I don't know. It's possible. Freight market. Fort Worth. To Ardmore. Not me. 9 hours left. I was going to Ardmore, right?
That's what you said, yeah.
Is that GPS destination? Well, it says my GPS destination is here, but now that I'm here, there's no pickup point. Unless I was talking and I missed it, which is possible. I'm not going to say that that's an impossibility.
70, State Route 70 to 375, Oklahoma 375. To 75 to 412 into Enid.
What it says, hold on.
Deep Wells. I am digging on all the new
companies.
Yeah. I'm really digging on it. All right, so 412, we're looking to go again one more time. 70 out of Idabel. We're going to pick up 375, where 70 is going to continue on to Ardmore, but we're going to take 375 north. It will turn into 75, and then we're going to get on the 244 interchange and hook up with 412 headed west.
I may have to pick up a different load because I'm here.
Okay.
And I don't have anything that's showing me. Okay, here's the thing with the trailer on it. That's weird. Sorry, didn't mean to. I didn't mean to jump in and know what you were saying there. It was like,
that's all right. Okay. Hey, it quite literally is your world. So.
okay, here we go. Ardmore. Okay, there
driving
we go.
For EPR. Our first load for EPR. Whoop. There's a train going by, so we had to wait for that.
Who's EPR? What's that again?
Turn left.
They're some kind of a chemical company.
Okay.
Let me see here. Yeah, it just says EPR, so I'm not exactly sure what the EPR stands for.
I'm taking that gravel articulated trailer here. Pull right underneath this thing. What could go wrong? They're doing a lot of business out here at the Namik and Fort Worth, dude.
Getting rain.
Yeah, so I've been to Fort Worth in real life to visit a friend once. And I liked it. And it looks a lot like this. It is always neat to catch a glimpse of the places you've been in real life.
Yeah, recognize different stuff, yeah.
Yeah.
That's why I can't wait. I was talking in my earlier runs. I can't wait to get to South Dakota.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love South Dakota. So I can't wait to see how they what they do with it. You know, it'll be fun.
Yeah. All right, so I'm taking excavated soil, 28,000 pounds from the Ardmore Taylor to the Ardmore Taylor construction. They need it there Saturday, 12:41 a.m. Saturday, 12:41 a.m. Friday, 11:11 to 7. Okay, so I gotta get going.
Yeah, you do. That guy is driving fast because it's raining and he's got a convertible with the top down.
Power, lights. All right, we're good to go. We got power, we got electricity. Hop back in the cab. Yeah, time talking about lights. Time to put our lights on, my friend. 6:17 p.m. Don't get you a ticket.
No, sir. I haven't seen a speed limit sign yet. About 60. Whoa! Ghosting over a little bit.
Yeah, so this is game, we've played, 18 games now? This will be game 19 we got coming up for the Beewolves?
I believe so, yes.
All right. And then pretty soon after that, we'll do the midway point live from the Hive. And we'll take a look at Super Mega 4 just before that. Try and figure out what next season's gonna look like.
Yes, sir. Start to talk about possible teams. Now we will select for our Super Mega Baseball 4 team.
Yes, sir.
Figure out if we can afford to get rid of anybody maybe overpriced, pick up somebody else. Try to pick up some training regimen here before the end of the season, and I think this is probably going to be more to the point. I think we'll probably just keep the team as is.
Yeah.
You know, and just try to get to the end of the season. I think we're going to wind up with, not us, because this is our last season with the Beebles, but I think we'd wind up with, look at this, the clouds in the rearview mirror. That's crazy. But I think we're going to wind up with a lot of retirements. I don't know how much longer Longballo is going to hang around.
Yeah.
Even when you talk about Dexteris, I mean, at this point, he's no rookie, you know?
Yeah.
Bertha Banks, she hasn't been playing as well as she usually does. So I think this might be, I'd be interested in seeing what happens at the end of the season.
Yeah.
I kind of feel like maybe we're gonna be seeing a lot of people leave the team.
Yeah, and I mean, I, some of that's kind of a moot point as well, even like with the way the next season's going to be.
Right.
It's going to be almost a, you know, complete restructure, and we got to figure out what that, you know, how those dots connect. Oh, thanks, pal. This guy let me out. Here, the Brum crossing the Brazos River. Oops.
It's a cashless toll booth. Do not stop.
Caution, please mind the speed.
$13 paid, just flew right through it. Actually flew through it a little bit too quickly, if you ask me. I was outside, so I'm riding along, and all of a sudden I see a sign. I'm like, oh, I better get in. And obviously, before you can really even get settled in, the thing's on you. Look at that sky. That's nuts.
I know. This is
beautiful sky.
Sunset.
Yeah. I got rain, though.
Oh, you're still in southeast Oklahoma right now, or where are you at?
I believe so. I'm making my way up. I need to zoom out a little bit. Let me try this. Whoop. Yeah, I think I'm heading north. Yep. Heading north.
I'm just now coming up to Fort Worth again.
That was kind of sad because I jumped in, I did those Oklahoma trips, and I'm trying to do the cruising Oklahoma, you know, situation.
Yeah.
So you have to take the external contracts, but I wanted to take the cattle. I wanted to take a live load because I'd never taken one before, and I was right there by the grand pastures. So I was like, oh, cool. If I could get a live load, that'd be slick, man.
Yeah, yeah. That would be. I am, I'm pulling over the side of the road real quick here. I'm gonna get a picture of Fort Worth, Texas. I might as well.
Yes, sir.
Texas and Pacific Lofts. Go here. All right. Very cool.
Whoa, whoa. The sunset right now is crazy. I'm trying to do as much as I can to try and get some video of me driving along, and I'm swerving and floating in my lane like crazy.
Well, I just pulled over on the side of the highway to Yeah, so I could have caused a situation there. But it was a photo op. I got one of those, you know, photo awards for taking a picture of the iconic building down here in Fort Worth.
Very cool.
Yeah, I decided not to do the cruising Oklahoma thing. I got burnt out on Montana when I didn't really like basically bum rushing the whole state.
Yeah.
In one fell swoop, you know. I was kind of like, well, I went from not being in the state at all to like only not having seen two cities in a matter of a week and a half. I kind of like bouncing around.
I hear you. I feel the same way.
What do you get for it?
Go straight on.
Well, if you do your job, you will get a paint job.
A paint job?
Yeah, you get a Stampede paint job.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Which I believe is the Stampede is bison.
Oh, wow. Well, yeah, you got to do it then. It's for PJ.
Yeah, and then if you get the, if the community does the job, oh, come on, man, you killed me. This freak from Technoma. pulled out in front of me and then slammed on it. I was doing 65. I'm now doing 39.
That's come on. When you're slowing trucks down, you're the problem.
Well, he is a truck. But then I wanted to pass him, but because I had to downshift, my automatic downshifted so much, I couldn't get it going. I had my turn signal on. Everybody's just, they were very nice. The cars were holding back, but I'm like, I can't get enough speed to get around this guy. You might as well go ahead.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm noticing this now, too. I see these high-altitude aircraft now flying over. Which is cool. They're not landing at the nearby airport, you know. They're
got an interchange going on here. Boy, they are doing some work here, bro. It's a clover leaf. Putting in a clover leaf here.
Oh, boy. This is, that's quite an interchange I was just at there. I'm glad I didn't tip anything.
Tulsa discovered.
Hey-o.
Although,
yeah, Tulsa.
I'm driving past it on the freeway, so I'm not seeing much of it.
Yeah, I've got some of that, you know, where it's like, I know there's cities, I forget where it was at, somewhere in West Texas. What's that one? I'm like, I've technically discovered it, but I know I passed through it on the highway.
Right.
Please mind the speed.
So there's a lot of that.
Yeah, that happens on all the maps. It's always happened. I kind of don't like it. There's Tulsa. Because like you say, that's what happens. Am I going to Enid?
Keep left.
I think
Enid
I am.
Exit left.
Yeah, and so you're driving by on the highway. It's like, you've discovered it. And it's like, well, I didn't even go in. That's
yeah.
Not. Gotta go left. I thought that would be
not really fair.
Yeah. Although I'm getting off at Tulsa. I'm switching up.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be picking up, but I'm turning in the opposite direction. So I got off. Making our way back. Here we go. Coming over.
Camera changes or something. All right, I got a sign here. Oklahoma City 106. Ardmore 46. I'm only 46 outside of Ardmore. I'm at the Red River. The Red River gal. Hey, welcome to Oklahoma. I'm here, man.
All right, enjoy it.
I'm in the Sooner State.
Drink it in.
Yes,
in
sir.
All its inky darkness.
Yeah. Now, the family's from Nebraska, so Big Red Machine and the Sooners, Cornhuskers and the Sooners aren't, it's like
friends.
Oil and water.
They don't get along, them guys.
I remember 1986. Was it 1986? When they were in the Orange Bowl. Stinking Oklahoma. The last time when they had Tom Landry, that was the best the Huskers have ever been. All right, let's see. We got to stop at the truck way station. Beautiful starry night out down here, my friend. How's it up there?
Beautiful. Rolling along, doing about 4.9 miles per gallon.
I got almost 70,000 pounds of gross weight.
Oop.
See.
Cashless toll booth.
Caution, please mind the speed.
This was my opportunity to see what I needed for sleep, and I wasn't even paying attention.
What is the speed limit through there, 15?
Where are you going through a town?
No, I'm going through another cashless toll booth. There's quite a few of them. On the way to, where am I going? I keep forgetting where I'm going. Going to
Enid,
yeah. Sorry, brother. I had to look at my waybill real quick. You know how that is. You're a truck driver. You know how that is.
Yeah. Sometimes you got to take your eyes off the road when you're going around a turn.
That's right.
My waybill. Okay, I'm at
a fly through. Cashless toll booth at 80 miles per hour.
Almost finest pulling somebody over there. safe state here in Oklahoma.
Yes, sir. They don't mess around. They think they're driving laws seriously here.
So Kansas is next, huh?
Yeah, it looks that way. They're a lot quicker at turning out the American states than they are. We talked about that before.
Yeah.
So I'm wondering how long it'll be. They put up that page on Steam. Like I say, ATS doesn't seem like it sits for too long. We just got Texas not that long ago.
Yeah, right.
And now we got Oklahoma. So again, same thing with Nebraska. The other thing about these states, they're big, but there's not a lot of towns. I think we talked about that too. Well, once you cross the Mississippi River, you start talking about a lot more cities. A lot more roads, you know, and so you start getting into. I think that's going to probably start being a little bit more difficult when you start getting into the. You just look at the map, you know, and look at the road map of the United States, and you see that there's just, you know, 80 and 90, you know, those are your main. Come on, dude, why would you get on the highway?
Go straight on.
In front of me and do that. But then, like I said, when you look at Illinois, there's so many different roadways and stuff.
Yeah.
I think, you know, they're going to have to start being a lot more selective. There's no way you're going to be able to render all of them, you know? So you're going to have to start being a lot more selective about which ones you're going to include. And I'd be interested in seeing that, too, just how they do Illinois.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, next is going to be, obviously, Kansas and then Nebraska. I don't know why these guys are stopping, but okay. I think I'm gonna guess they're gonna do the Dakotas as one.
I think you're right. Well, as one, I don't know.
North and South Dakota, because
you could. Again, North Dakota. I don't know if there's many roadways up there, and there's Bismarck, but I'm not outside of that. I don't know if they have very many big cities.
Yeah, I mean, it's not empty. It'll be, and it's, you know, geographically speaking, there'll be, you know, a good amount of road that they'll be able to put there. But
at least five. They'll have at least five roads.
But I got to imagine that most of their time is spent modeling out at least urban or suburban areas.
Yeah.
Whereas the open road's a little bit easier to. Probably, I don't know. I mean, that's just my guess. But I hope I make this delivery on time.
And like we were saying, it's South Dakota. I'm in Enid. Welcome to Enid, everybody. South Dakota has a lot of more tourist attractions and stuff. We talked about Sturgis and Deadwood and Mount Rushmore and Crazy Horse. And, just a lot more natural. Well, not so much. I mean, Mount Rushmore and Crazy Horse, while they are rocks, they are not natural. They're carved.
Right, right. Yeah, I'm sorry.
It would be something if they just formed that way, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
This is our natural wonder.
Right.
This just happened like it is. We didn't do nothing to it.
I realize I'm supposed to be turning right here. Like, somebody honked, and then they're all gonna be because I'm in the right turn lane and I gotta go straight.
I almost missed the stop sign. I was flying up and it was one of those things where it just seemed to pop out of nowhere and I'm like, oh, whoa, whoa. Yeah. Train crossing, that's another one. That thing in the dark.
I know, my business is registered out of Nevada. I'm a long way from home. So Phoenix, we might be leaving Phoenix.
Well, that was the other thing too, is the thing we had kind of talked about before was we would always take like the worst team from the previous season.
Oh yeah.
And we would try to build them up. So I don't know if we're gonna stay with that.
Yeah. I don't know how you'd. Man, I gotta stop coming up on intersections at like 50 miles an hour. You know, I'm just. slamming and working these brakes. I should find that out. Ooh, it's a long one. Do they model brake wear?
I don't think so.
If I'm wrenching my brakes all the time, is that...
Recomputing.
They should have truck mechanic simulator where you can work on people's trucks.
I missed my turn. Can you believe that?
Wow, this is a little...
I am horrible at picking up the driveways in the dark. I can't see them. And I just fly right past them.
Well, they're building here at 11:07 on a Friday night. And I'm coming in here with some gravel. Fort Worth, Ardmore, Oklahoma. And I'm gonna get right into my little spot here. Chop.
Go straight on.
Okay. Step outside. Oh, come on, you're kidding me. I overdid it. Okay. These people, Pete.
I tell you what. I got an international dealership here in Enid.
All right. An international. Okay, good to know. Oh, good to know. All right, so now I don't need to go to Enid.
Everybody's got to go to Enid. Everybody.
So I got to see what's in town here. And then
it looks like
Kenworth.
I'm going to try and pull a U here.
It's Kenworth. So if I go, oh, a second. If I go Oklahoma City's the other one, maybe I could see on the map. Question mark. Okay, so I cannot tell. I need to go to Oklahoma City and find out if that's a back dealer. So I'm gonna have to grab another load.
Go straight on.
Okay, City.
Okay.
It's just the right thing to do.
God dang it. Does that seem to be recognizing my... I'm gonna have to check my settings. My brakes are... I'm putting my foot on the brake. And it's like, no reaction, no reaction, no reaction. And then, you know, so I keep increasing the pressure a little bit. And then all of a sudden it's like, ah! And you're like, what the what is happening? I'm either missing my stop or I'm blowing, you know, or I'm slamming on my brakes. Turning on my right turn signal. There it is, right there. Okay, we're going to pull this puppy right in there. There she is. One load of aromatics. No accidents. No tickets. No nothing.
Alright, I'm gonna go grab a frac tank, the Vortex, and bring it on up to OK City. It's only gonna bring in $3,600, but that way at least I'll find out what all the hubbub's about.
What's all the hubbub, bub?
Talk about no downtime between jobs. Right?
You are right.
Midnight, coming up on Saturday morning. My trailer's out. Yeah, they're building homes here in Ardmore, man. We build them at midnight, Friday. Taylor Construction.
Those homes have already been sold, Tom. We gotta get them up and going here, brother.
Ardmore? I consider Ardmore, Oklahoma.
Obviously, you're not the only one.
Yeah. Nice little church down the street here. Oh, what was that? my second run is going to be to OK City. All right. I like their license plates. Why am I... I not kill it. Killed it somehow. Community church. Ooh, lady. Okay. Well, they'll be open for business in a day or so. Oops, oops. There's the fire department here at Ardmore. On the way to the board. Oh, there's a, what's it called? A scenic view here, which I'm going to pull in and see, even though it's the middle of the night on a Friday.
All right, let's see here.
Because I don't know when I'm going to be through Ardmore again, so. And I've got an external contract as well, so it's not expiring real quick.
No, sir.
Calm down, Doug. Move a little forward. All right. Ardmore, Oklahoma. Let's see what's going on here. We're going to shut the engine down. We're going to step outside, and we're going to hit enter. Here we go, Pete.
You're still traveling with Doug?
Yeah.
You know, Sky's got a sister. Excellent work. 301 miles, 37 minutes, 57.2 gallons.
Time. Flaring natural gas here. As the Baptist Church.
I think that's
Sunday 9 a.m. Community Church. Some of the local construction where I just help these guys build.
Let's do this.
You can see this expansion at Ardmore is partially my help. The Ardmore Stadium, home of the Ardmore Champions.
That's because they're only playing people in Ardmore.
Very cool. Alright, I'll pop inside.
Turn this thing on. Yes, sir.
Turn left.
Pick up my load and then head out of Dodge because I'm gonna have to get some coffee.
Me too.
Probably went around the wrong way, so I'm just gonna hook hard right here.
We got one more thing to discover in Enid, but I think it's just a U-hire, so.
All right.
And then we'll grab some coffee, and then there's a photo spot, so I think when I get up from the coffee, I'm gonna.
Keep right.
I gotta start a security check.
Security check?
Yeah, they're checking me out here, because that's a.
Turn right.
It's a the Vortex security check passed. You may proceed. It's a production plant. This is like an area of national security, man. If this was a terrorist attack, this place would be on the map.
Keep left, and then
could they do their due diligence? Like Tommy G. Pete J and Tommy G, Tommy G? Yeah.
Okay, I hit.
I'm the lesser famous of the two.
Hit an invisible wall, because again, I couldn't see this stupid drive. I've just got to figure it out. Okay. When she says get ready to turn right, just start turning right. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter where you are or what you're doing, but just turn right, because that's, she's there.
All right, this is my frac tank. These oil and gas people are my peeps. So, a little interesting story. When I lived in the city, I had a friend who had a friend. And this friend of a friend was a drummer in a band. Like, traveled across Europe. Reminded me a lot of your nephew.
Uh-huh.
And basically, a lot like him. But, you know, like, total beefcake dude, total fun guy. And then I find out recently on LinkedIn that he's like, he's now the president of his own company.
Oh, wow.
And cool. At least he was. And he was living in West Texas, and his company painted the seal coating, painting on these tanks that hold, fuel products.
Oh, wow.
And they were really good at it. And so he was just painting these tanks and churning out big bucks. Because it's like, it's a special kind of seal coating that, you know, to be, not just be waterproof is one thing, but, you know, hold butane and ethane and other things that, like, you know, highly corrosive at super low temperatures and everything. It's just super impressive to just get, you know, that whole, it's like, wow, I did not see that coming from this guy.
Right. You never know.
Didn't seem like the 9-to-5 type.
Right.
You know, but, all right. I got to go find somewhere. Parking brakes engaged? All right. I'll disengage from the parking brake. Frack tank looks like when they're pulling it out of the processing plant in Ardmore, Oklahoma, just past midnight on a Friday. By
all
a
right.
Well-seasoned professional like this guy.
Coffee Get time. All right, D-Wolves so plate. Lights are off. Oop, lights are off. We want that off. And shut her down. Went to grab a coffee. Okay.